Hey guys, this is the start of Unit 12. It is on thermochemistry and nuclear chemistry, and this slideshow is on forms of energy and then the law of conservation of energy at the end. The two main types of energy that you need to know are kinetic energy and potential energy. You have probably heard this all through school, all through your science classes. So we'll kind of review kinetic energy and potential energy, and then we'll talk about a couple other types of energy. One thing to note is that kinetic plus potential energy equals your total amount of energy. Kinetic energy is the energy of particles, waves, atoms, molecules, or any substance that is in motion. So a few examples of that would be electrons that are moving around. When you throw a ball, the ball's moving, that's kinetic energy. Walking down the street, or even when you're starting to go downhill on a roller coaster. All of that is kinetic energy. Potential energy is energy that an object has because of its position relative to other objects. It has the potential to be converted into other forms of energy, such as kinetic. So potential energy is when something's not moving just yet, but it's about to start moving and that potential turns into kinetic. An example would be a ball right before you throw it, your jaw right before you start chewing food, and also energy that's stored as fat in the body. It's not being used yet, but it could be eventually. Chemical potential energy, this is a new one. This is the energy stored in the bonds of chemical compounds. It can be released during a chemical reaction, so when those bonds are being broken. And it's usually in the form of heat, so an exothermic reaction. It releases heat. Chemical energy can be used to create heat and electricity. Examples would be wood, batteries, explosives, food, oil, and many other things that you see in that picture. Thermokinetic energy, which is basically just heat, it's produced when a rise in temperature causes atoms and molecules to move fast and start colliding with each other. The higher the temperature, the more thermal energy an object has. Examples of this would be boiling water, heat from a fire or a heater in your home, and just the human body, the heat that your body produces. The law of conservation of energy, it's a lot like any other law of conservation that we've seen so far. It states that energy cannot be created or destroyed. It can be changed from one form into another, or it can be transferred from one object to another. So kinetic plus potential, equals total energy. But total energy could also be broken down into kinetic and potential energy. An example would just be lighting a stick of dynamite. The dynamite contains chemical energy and potential energy. Then when you light it, it starts to explode. The energy is converted into kinetic energy, and then thermal energy is released in heat. And then we also have some sound and some light. The three ways of heat transfer or thermal energy are convection, conduction, and radiation. So you probably heard about this 7th and 8th grade. This is kind of a review. Convection is a way that heat travels. It occurs when heat is transferred by the movement of liquid or gases. Okay, so in that little pot that's on the stove there, convection is those molecules moving around inside and starting to have heat transferred. Conduction is the movement of heat from one object to another when they're touching each other. So conduction, it has to actually be touching. Radiation is the transmission of energy in the form of waves or particles through space or through a material medium. So radiation, there's heat coming off that stove that you can feel even though you're not touching it. You can also think about radiation from the sun. We're getting energy and heat from the sun, but we're not touching anything. It's going through space. Heat always moves from hot to cold. Okay, so that's it for this slide. I will be uploading some more notes pretty soon. Bye, guys.